come to this race every year because it's the World Championships. You can call yourself the world champ if you win it, and you can't do that after any other race. So it's definitely a big one. You know, for me, I've always kind of looked at the World Cup overall as the big one, but I've won it a few times and I haven't won World Champs. So one of those races that's kind of like first or last sort of thing. Second doesn't really get you much. So everybody's going for a win. So it's, you know, I got to just put together my best run when it counts and just go for it, you know, full gas. And if you break yourself off, you got 7 months to heal. So we're going to try not to let that happen. But it is nice having it the last race of the year.
Yeah, it's pretty wild here in Norway. There's, you know, mountains everywhere. It's, you know, big lakes, and the friggin' roofs on the houses have grass on it. It's just crazy. It's a different place to go, that's for sure. And it's kind of, you know, last race of the season, and it's the one for all the glory. And, you know, you gotta throw everything you've got into one race run and not worry about any series or any, you know, points this time. You know, it's just one run that you're not gonna get first by just getting down the hill. So, yeah, because it's last race of the season and it's world champs, people are just gonna be taking a lot of risks and getting pretty wild.
The competition level between the riders now is it really is insane. You know, the time gaps are so minimal. There's 10 or 15 guys that can win, really. I think that adds a little bit to the pressure of having to have the perfect run and having to have every line perfect. You know, if you miss one section in practice, that it's not just the run, it's the whole thing. Like, you have to be on point on your track walk. You have to be on point on practice. You know, one of the sneaky lines, if you don't find it and the other guys do, the guys that can manage the pressure and remember their lines and all the, you know, what they've been doing in practice and execute on it, those are the guys that are going to have good days.
The track's, you know, a little bit different. It's kind of bike parking really fast. So it's going to be, you know, a couple of lines in the tight trees and rock sections. But apart from that, it's just going to be kind of who can rail the berms and scrub the jumps the fastest and hold speed. I think that's the main thing here, just trying to really stay light through the rock gardens and kind of hold speed in between sections.
One of those tracks where a lot of it you're kind of almost race pace first run, and then a lot of it is it's gonna sort of take some trial and error. I think you just gotta try some different things and see which works better. So, but I feel great. Everything's healthy, strong. Had a couple good weeks of training leading up to the race, so I got everything dialed.
Here we are, race day in Hafjell. World Championships. Boys are getting it done. Bikes are dialed. Aaron and Troy are ready. A lot of confidence in the tent today.
Yeah, just as the riders, race run has to be perfect. The bike has to be perfect on my end. You know, the bike is my race run. So yes, everything has to be perfect on it. And I check every single possible thing. I think the pressure on me is far less than what the riders experience. It's pretty crazy being up there at the top and being quiet. It's different. You know something important is about to happen, and it's a big sigh of relief when it's over.
Yeah, the start beeps, man. It's I tell you, when you hear those, it's everything else kind of goes silent around those start beeps. I mean, when you know when those beeps are going, that within seconds they're going to go off.
so close to that win and I wanted it so bad, but at the same time I just got an elite men's, you know, bronze medal at World Champs, and I'm stoked with that. Just to be up on the top, you know, almost every race is it's something special to me. So finally got some time off, get to go home with a bronze medal and get back training and come back stronger next year.
So I was happy to put together the run that I did, but it's sucks ending a year kind of less than where I know I should be, but it's at the same time it keeps you motivated in the off season. So yeah, just stoked, man. It was an awesome year for everybody. I can't thank the team enough for all the hard work they put in, and yeah, man, probably definitely the most fun I've ever had as far as a whole season, just enjoying racing, enjoying being able to ride my bike, and stoked for Troy, man. He definitely deserved it, getting third today, and he was close, man, real close.
Yeah, no, we had a really good weekend this weekend here in Hafjell. Jarl kicked off the podiums with a relay team, Howie and Leah, bronze medals in their XC events. And then we capped it off with Troy getting a third today in the elite men. So it's time to reflect on a fantastic season. Really want to thank the mechanics and all the staff for helping me out on this deal. So
2014 World Championships are over. Cross country, downhill, everybody under one roof here. Lots of fun, good results. It was an awesome season and awesome race. And now the party's on!